food fanatic is on a mission.
Ooh, that's got some kick to it.
To find the greatest, tastiest, hugest meals in America.
Yeah.
His name is Josh Jenkins, and this is Ginormous Food.
Welcome to Las Vegas. All the biggest names have played here. But in recent years, the real headlining act has been the food. My first stop, Truffles and Bacon Cafe, maybe a few miles from the bright lights of the Strip, but it's hit the jackpot, offering comfort food with a twist. Rollins?
People come from all over the city to come in here. It's packed.
It's off-strip, so I feel like it's kind of like a hidden gem for the locals.
Well, I mean, it's Vegas, right? So you kind of have to have something that makes you unique, and I think they've done it.
But nothing stands out like this burly burger bursting with flavor. The belly of the beast. Owner and head chef Jackie Lim has hit on a winning formula.
It's like exquisite home cooking.
You guys
know
what
it is?
And there are plenty of awesome tasting dishes to choose from.
I like the chicken and waffles. It just works.
My favorite is the Not Your Mama's Grilled Cheese. That's my go-to.
The Not Your Mama's Grilled Cheese is amazing.
Jackie, we've got sort of a regular grilled cheese here, but what makes it a not-your-mama grilled cheese?
A little bit of sauteed greens in it.
All right.
My famous bacon jam.
So you do your bacon jam from scratch here, right?
I have diced onions and smoked diced bacon. A liquid mix that I'm not going to...
Oh, yeah, a little bit of secrets in there.
It's in there. My very own spice. Put them together, and voila. The
I like that we're using all of this bacon jam, too.
Tomatoes.
Those look great. The meat of this sandwich is brisket that Jackie seasons with a secret rub, then roasts for 8 hours.
And then the brisket.
Look at that, it's beautiful. And this is ready to go. This is definitely what I would call a souped up grilled cheese.
Taste it.
I'm ready to taste it. Jackie, that's awesome. The bacon jam. Delicious. I don't know how you get so much flavor into something that's sort of so simple. The brisket seasoned perfectly. Love the cheddar.
Yeah, it browns up the whole thing.
It's really, really a delicious grilled cheese.
Thank
you. Not your mama.
Not your mama.
Not your mama's grilled cheese is the bomb.
But nothing explodes with flavor like Jackie's show-stopping extravaganza, the belly of the beast. I mean, first of all, we've got some huge ingredients here.
Yeah. This is ginormous.
I feel like you're pulling a prank on me. What if these are like tire-sized beef patties?
And you know, I like burgers. When I eat burgers, we just dribble.
Okay.
Yeah.
If you don't have meat bracelets,
no,
it's not good.
No, it's not a burger. It's not a burger. This is a pound of pork belly.
Got this 2.5
pounds of bread. A pound of hot cheese curl.
Some tater tots.
A pound of tots. A pound of shredded cheese.
And then what else goes on?
Top it off with 4 eggs. Sunny side up.
Well, we've got a lot of work to do. Jackie grills up her massive burger patties and the pork belly.
Some tomatoes. Serrano goes cut in half.
Serrano pepper. Here we go. Some tater tots.
Pound of tots.
Little cheese curls.
Cheese curls.
I didn't know you could saute cheese curls.
You can.
We got our hot cheese curl casseroles, if you will.
The 4 eggs.
The capper.
Because 5 is a little too much.
Yeah, I don't want to overdo anything. You gotta show restraint in the kitchen sometimes.
Okay, now we play.
Look at that. Got a beautiful crust on those burgers.
Okay, let's build it
let's
up.
Let's build this belly of the beast. So we gotta do our bun. Bring that over here. Put a nice, healthy dose of Korean mayo. It's something you guys make in-house. So we're gonna go a layer of this right on the bottom. Spicy cheese curls. Melted cheese, tater tots.
Then you put your burger on top.
Okay. This is just getting ridiculous already. We got that shallot pork belly in the middle.
You want to help?
I will help. I want to help. I'll help you by eating some of this.
And then another layer of
another burger. Did you feel like you were going nuts when you were making this?
Frankenstein.
It is like a Frankenstein of burgers. Oh, it smells so good.
Put your egg on top. Barbecue action.
Barbecue. We got a little ranch on there. Wow.
And
we're ready for the top. Or the manhole cover, if you will.
You can smoosh.
You smoosh it down. Oh, look at that. With the egg dripping and everything nice and gooey. Oh, man.
There you go.
That's it. That's the belly of the beast.
be able to fit this in one belly. Jackie, this is incredible.
No.
This is like a meat birthday cake. All right, we got it. Like, look at all those beautiful layers. I'm gonna go at it like this. Ready?
Ready.
But when you do, it's delicious. Beautiful top there.
$150 off. Go to Sapira.com.
You need this bed.
I'm in Las Vegas and I've got an ace up my sleeve. Rolling Smoke Barbecue.
Rolling Smoke Barbecue is the reason I come to Las Vegas.
It may be off the beaten path, but folks, line up for barbecue that can't be beat.
All the way from the Strip to Austin, you come here and you just eat to your heart's content.
This little hidden gem has a big time reputation.
And this place is fun, a lot of energy.
I've been all down south, but this is probably some of the best barbecue I think I've ever had.
And all that great barbecue comes together in one meat loving Herculean sandwich. The Triple Gutbuster. Chef Tim Hansen has brought his gung-ho personality.
Yeah, baby.
And his massive smokers to the Nevada desert.
This is how we do it right here, rolling smoke, man. Low and slow, man.
Now, what are some of your favorites here?
What I normally did, I probably did the barbecue chicken, and I think I might go with the brisket.
That's a good mix, meat and meat. Yeah. Best side dish for meat is other meat.
More meat.
Oh, I love the Spudtastic. The pork, the cheese, the pork you put on there, the better it is.
Up. So I'm assuming this is a potato dish.
This is a potato dish.
All right.
We're going to cut into that baby right here.
Right in the middle?
Right in the middle. Then we're going to fluff it up. Look at that. Like a pillow. Then we're going to hit it with some of this butter right here. Well, get it.
Yeah.
Butter. Now we're going to come with our kicking baked beans. We make our beans from scratch.
And of course, just about everything Tim makes has at least some of his signature barbecue. So we got some great meat here we're going to start with.
Yes, sir. Okay, we got our pork butt, our pork shoulders, got a full brisket right here, our rub that we put on everything.
Like, what's the core of your rub?
The core of it is Arkansas's backyard, your grandmother's kind of, don't tell nobody what you put in it.
Okay, so this is like the special secret.
We take fresh ingredients and mix them together. So we rub that and we let it marinate for 24 hours. So then we'll place it in the smoker for 14 hours, low and slow, at about 225. It is rolling smoke, so you gotta have some smoke rolling through there. Then that nice pulled pork.
Yeah, don't mind getting those crispy parts.
See that right there? You love that. That's some of the best parts right there. Then what I like to do then is I like to come back with our house sauce, our Arkansas sauce right here. We'll hit it with some cheese sauce right here. Oh, yeah. Yeah, baby. What is a baked potato without sour cream? Drizzle that down there. But I like to throw a little bit of fresh cheese on there as
this
well.
This is like the size of a collegiate football. And this is the Spudtastic.
That is the Spudtastic.
And this is beautiful. I mean, you usually think of baked potatoes as a side dish. This thing's a centerpiece.
I want everything in a bite.
Get that.
Call the thing a bucket of smiles because that's what I feel like it tastes like. The beans are amazing. The sauce in the beans, you can really taste the smoke in the pork. It's got all those classic baked potato elements. I mean, the only problem with this is I need to keep eating it.
Yes, sir.
The Spudtastic is my favorite thing, and it's so big, I always try to finish it, but I never can.
There are many massive dishes at Rollin' Smoke.
Yes.
My favorite dish is the Outlaw Burger. It is so big, you barely fit in your mouth, and it's awesome.